Night stargazing can be done from just about anywhere, including potentially your own neighborhood. But you'll be able to see more if there aren't a lot of tall structures or light pollution. Light pollution is the brightening of the sky by artificial sources like streetlights. Once you've found a location, there are some basic things you'll want to pack, including a blanket. You'll be looking up at the night sky, so lying on a blanket will keep you from getting a stiff neck. Dress appropriately for the weather. Bring food and water if you're going out for an extended period of time. You'll need a flashlight, but not any old flashlight. If you can, get one with a red light. It'll do a better job at protecting your night vision. If you have binoculars and a telescope, pack them. We're packing just binoculars for this trip. A phone is helpful to have in case of an emergency. It's also going to be an astronomy tool. There are a bunch of great apps that can help identify what you're looking at. Try a couple and see what works for you. Lastly, if you're going to a more isolated area, like a national park, you may want to check with your local park service about wildlife or weather. Once you get to the site and set up, give your eyes some time to adapt to the night sky. It can take up to 30 minutes for your eyes to fully adapt for the best night vision. Be careful. One quick look at a bright light or your phone screen means you'll have to start adapting all over again. Then it's time to start stargazing. With just the naked eye, you should be able to identify the moon if it's up. If you're a beginner, it might be hard to figure out what you're looking at, but an app or a star map can help. Just point your phone at the sky and it'll help you identify objects. Depending on the time of year and your location, you may see bright stars like Vega, the gas dust from the Milky Way, some planets, and even the International Space Station. If you have binoculars, even inexpensive ones, you'll be able to see some pretty cool stuff with them. Point them at the moon, and you might be able to see some craters. So as you can see, you don't need a big expensive telescope or to be out in the remote wilderness. Sometimes all you need to do is take a minute and look up.